Okay, so here we go again. So my name is still Hans de Goede, and I still work for Red Hat. I mostly am supposed to be working on input stuff, but somehow I also ended up looking at backlight issues. I am not going to talk about fixing all the backlight issues, despite what Martin said. This is mostly about issues with the API. So there are some things in the API which are not completely clear how they're supposed to work, and recently they have surfaced and been causing us some problems. This is mostly meant as a discussion talk, so please interrupt me whenever you have something to remark. So I'll be very short, hopefully a lot shorter than our previous speakers. Maybe we can get a little bit back on schedule. There are two problems with the current API, and there are some ideas to actually adding a backlight property to the DRM connector so that we completely get rid of the SysFS API. Well, we don't really get rid of it, but newer user space can use a more convenient way to set backlight. So what are the causes of the problems we're having today? We have had Windows 8 for a while now, and Microsoft did some things with Windows 8 which basically boil down to all the ACPI implementations for setting backlight, what we call the firmware interfaces, are now broken on 90% of the Windows 8 laptops. So as soon as we see a BIOS which queries for Windows 8 support, so we assume the BIOS is written for Windows 8, we stop using the firmware interfaces because they tend to not be reliable. We had like a blacklist which was growing every kernel release, so we sort of inverted the check. Native interfaces, however, are what has exposed the subtleties or the not clearly defined areas of the backlight SysFS API. And that causes problems for user space because now things behave differently because they're talking to a native interface, specifically the Intel backlight driver, because that's used on 90% of all laptops. So what are the current API issues? Issue one is, what does zero as a brightness setting mean? The SysFS interface has two attributes, two relevant attributes in this discussion: backlight power, where you can say turn the backlight off, and a brightness attribute. With firmware implementations with the ACPI video interface or a vendor-specific firmware interface like the Dell or ThinkPad backlight interfaces, zero meant lowest possible backlight setting. So you could press minus on your backlight key all the way down to the lowest level, and you would still see something on your screen. With the Intel backlight driver, this got fixed recently, or at least partly fixed.
We didn't really fix this to fix the interface issue, but because if you set it to zero, you piss certain panels off.
Okay.
So it's not like a valid value to set at all. But there's still machines out there. If you set it to zero, it's dark.
Yes, so that's why I said partially fixed. Okay. But it, as a side effect, it may make this issue less severe. But anyways, this is a problem. This is an inconsistency in our interface, which user space needs to deal with. I also have a suggestion for fixing this, which is basically, first of all, document in the API documentation how this is supposed to work. So basically, my question is, are there any objections to documenting that a brightness setting of zero means minimum workable brightness and not off? How do I break Chrome OS?
Because they presume that zero means off, because they use the native backlight driver in Intel, because they don't have an ACPI backlight driver. The situation is totally screwed up. Yes.
So, but Chrome OS is a very tightly controlled environment anyway. So ABI issues aren't that big there. So they will update the kernel and user space in sync anyway. So maybe we should just break Chrome OS. I think if you look at the original ABI documentation and you look at the intention, the fact that there is a separate backlight power attribute suggests that zero means minimum brightness and not off.
If zero means lowest possible setting, then it means minus on your which might be off.
with some panels, like, you see a little bit of light, but it's totally not useful. So either you have someone who sets a useful lowest setting, which no one can do but the OEM, or you have just undefined behavior and just don't go like that. I know this. The problem, it's not just Chromos. I think we had the other bug reports from crazy non-genome desktop environments and people screaming like, yeah, the endless loop doesn't work anymore, the XKCD example. It's like, I really don't want to touch the meaning of that thing.
But currently it's broken.
Oh, well, yeah.
And aren't we supposed to fix things when they're broken?
The problem is, I don't know on all machines like what is still visible. It's like no one tells us that.
Well, one of the problems is that if you have a pretty raw backlight control, which pretty much translates one-on-one to a PWM duty cycle, then it's not just zero which is off, but it could be 0 to 10 which is off out of the 0 to 1,000, or 0 to 20 which is off, or 0 to 30 which is off. And to me, this is a clear case of this is hardware abstraction. The kernel needs to fix this. I'm not saying we can fix this tomorrow. I'm suggesting we define that zero means lowest usable brightness setting, and then we can slowly over time try to actually fix it. But I think, first of all, we need to accept that this is a kernel bug.
I guess what we could do is add like a bold Sisyphus property thing that does a soft limit kind of thing that UDEV sets with a massive database or whatever that tells the kernel, please don't go below this. Or tells user space, it's not a good idea to go below this. I don't think the kernel can actually fix this.
It used to work in the ACPI video days until Microsoft
because
sort
everyone
of broke.
Used ACPI. The thing is, all the other backlight drivers just means zero means off. And we had people screaming at us when we did that patch. And it was not just the Chrome people, like, please reinstate that. This is a regression. It's like, it kills your panel.
Okay, so an alternative suggestion would be to put in the documentation that if the type of backlight interfaces have types, if it's a firmware interface, user space may assume that zero is minimum usable level. And that if it's a native interface, that user space is out of luck.
Yeah,
that's not my version. But I guess, so if I'm going to send a patch which does this, you're going to neck it.
Yeah, I'm going to hate it.
You're going to hate it, but are you going to neck it?
When I implemented native backlight support in Radeon, ended up doing zero meaning off because every other backlight driver does that.
Well, except ACPI on Intel. And unfortunately, that's what 90% people use and all the genome people use.
And Dell backlight and Acer backlight, Asus backlight, ThinkPad backlight, but all the firmware ones. But so I guess I'm feeling most consensus here for just putting a text in there that it depends on the backlight type. That for firmware, it's supposed to be lowest level, and for native, it's... Is it off, or is it all bets are off? I would prefer to give user space some sanity, so maybe document that zero means off for native interfaces. Oh, right, because you have the Chrome OS issue. Okay, so... If anyone has any clever ideas, drop a mail to me or drop a mail to the list. Apparently, this is not solved. Current API issue 2 is that all the firmware interfaces have a mapping between usually 15 or 16 levels for some reason, and the actual PWM settings, which is a table, which is not linear, because there's such a thing as perceived brightness. So what the user sees as a higher brightness level, which is somewhat an exponential scale. Human eyes are not linear for some reason. So now we've stopped using the firmware interface everywhere on Intel, or x86, AMD2. We're using the native interface. We're actually more or less directly setting the PWM duty cycle, and which sort of corresponds to electrical power. That actually depends on whether we're controlling current or voltage, because if it's voltage, then it's squared. But at least it's not perception. That's actually an interesting problem, by the way, that we also need to know if we're controlling voltage or amperage. Do you know that? I'm looking at the native backlight guys. Can you tell user space this setting controls the voltage which goes to the backlight? Or yeah, but PWM can control amps, amperage, through controlling...
No, it's turning it on and off. It's just blinking it.
It's just blinking it really fast.
Yeah, that's what PWM means.
Okay, so you're in essence, you're always setting a percentage of the electrical power because you do the on-off time.
Yeah.
It never goes to something like a regulated... current supply, and then that's or fancy
that
stuff
would be
like
expensive.
That. Right. Okay. So it pretty much maps one on one to electrical power, a percentage of the maximum electrical power. Okay, because that's hopefully something. Despite that, not all LEDs will have the same curve. But oh no, it's percentage. So it actually the power curve of the LEDs.
All the LEDs should react in the same way.
Yeah, because it's time based. It's not. You're not
and they
controlling
take a few nanoseconds to light. So
yep.
The PWM frequency can be very low. I don't know, like a kilohertz. So it shouldn't matter.
It still doesn't matter. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
So this is pretty much, the native ones are pretty much setting a percentage of maximum electrical output. That's usable because assuming people agree this is a problem, I have had complaints from users about this, so some people see this as a problem. I would like to solve this. And the solution which I think we could do, or there are two options. One is adding a brightness scale attribute, which will be a new Sysfs attribute, which will basically tell user space this is perceived brightness, right? So you can use this linearly and the user will be happy. Or you're setting raw electrical power, do something yourself to make the user happy that it is what the user wants. Or we could actually, since we were discussing before, to document differences between native type and firmware type, we could do that.
Actually, I guess that could be useful together with like this zero mean off. Because if it's like linear scaling electrical power, then yes, zero means off, because no power, no light. But if it's like perceived brightness, it's probably some log scale.
But zero does not mean off with the Intel driver when it respects the minimum VBT value.
Well, yeah, we're screwed.
So maybe we need a separate SysFS attribute which says whether zero means off or not.
Well, I'm actually not sure if that lowest setting is anything useful. Whether it's just like this does not kill the panel.
I see. That would explain some bug reports which I have seen even after that patch got merged. There are still complaints that even after that patch that zero means off or perceived off.
Well, I guess on some older machines the VBT doesn't have that like field.
Okay.
Or yeah, some panels like probably don't need it or have not.
Right. So so another option to this would be, but I'm already feeling that the answer to this option is going to be no, is there were some discussions on the Intel graphics list to actually do a mapping that's already being done now because of the minimum VBT thingy between the hardware value and the value seen in SysFS, and to maybe just always present a scale between 0 and 100, or 0 and 255, whatever you think is a nice value. If you're going to do that mapping anyway, and maybe you can also solve this problem there, or all the problems there. But I have a feeling that that's sort of out of your hands, basically. That the machines are too broken, you don't have enough info in the kernel, so.
Yeah.
Yes. But I guess that the top one is sort of possible, or
Assuming you go with the first one, what exactly would you expect user space to do with information?
Sorry, say again?
In practice, if you let user space know which scale it is, what do you think user space would do with this information?
I expect them in one case to have linearly set as you press your brightness down in 20 steps or whatever they think is the right number, the power, and in the other case that they will set the value mapped to an exponential scale.
I mean, in practice, the user just presses a key on the keyboard to increase or decrease the brightness, and there's like 7 or 8 levels possible. I don't quite see how you can remap this.
If you have, that's with the firmware interfaces, then there are like maybe 7 levels or 15 levels exposed. But if you have the raw interface, it can go up to like 4,000 or 8,000 levels.
Okay.
You don't want the user to press the down page, the down key, brightness down key 7,000 times to get to a reasonable level. So what user space does is it takes the entire range and it divides it by 20. And if that's more than one, then it does that as step size. So it assumes it's linear.
Okay, I get it.
But that
now
leads to, thanks, on some laptops, that means you cannot really reach the lowest usable backlight value because you go from still pretty bright to unusable in one step. So user space would need to put a curve there. And we can either put the curve in the kernel, but I think no one here wants to do that. Or we can tell user space you need to put some fancy curve here. And then the GNOME guys can solve it and the KDE guys can solve it a second time. And
Why not put the curve into the hardware database and then just make GNOME retrieve it for every different backlight? And you can also solve the zero thing with it by simply setting the lowest point of the curve to 1 or 10 or whatever it is.
Right. But that means that someone needs to sit down for every new model laptop.
No, I mean, you still have a default and you only put it into the database if it doesn't work. The default is kind of ugly if you have to match on the on the backlight type, but it's still better than putting one entry for every device.
Okay. So you're I can see that working. That's probably where we'll end up anyway, that we need a database and we might as well put it in user space. But would we then still do this, or would we just assume that if it's a native type, it has the we will pick a curve as default, and if it's a firmware type, we will pick linear as default.
No, please not. we already have examples in the ARM world where we have a native interface in terms of a PVM backlight, and yeah, we have the mapping in the kernel because we describe it in the device tree, and some vendor actually did the work of mapping.
Okay, so
UM levels to some perceived brightness on the.
But it is a native. So you're saying the Sisyphus attribute is a good idea?
Yes.
Okay.
You want to have some way to express from the kernel to say to user space, okay, I don't know what the scale is. I have no idea. Do whatever you want. Or, okay, I have exact information and. Yeah, it's a perceived brightness.
Okay, so basically you're suggesting that the other value compared to perceived brightness is unknown.
Right.
Okay. I think we can do something with that. So the other thing is just mostly a convenience thing. This is something which Intel is actually already sort of doing, but they're doing it in user space. The Intel X86 video Intel driver is adding a backlight property to the X-Render connector, but that's all happening at that level. And there has been some discussion before to actually do this in the kernel, so hopefully make it more consistent and strip out some code out of the X86 Intel driver and, of course, benefit Wayland, which doesn't have video-specific drivers yet. So the idea is that backlight really is something which does not belong in some random Sisyphus file which needs root rights to modify, but that it belongs as a property on the connector, right? Backlight doesn't make sense for my HDMI output, it doesn't make sense for my VGA output, but it does make sense for my LCD panel. So it should be a property of that connector. The problem is that we have multiple SysFS interfaces, right? On some laptops, we have both a firmware one and a native one, and one may work or may not work, or we may have multiple firmware ones of which only one works. So the mapping of the interface to a connector is a problem. A couple of weeks ago, I think, maybe slightly longer, I was talking to David Herman about this, and he let me know that he was thinking about actually doing this and then adding a way for user space to do the binding, right? So if there's no way for the kernel to know how the two belong together, then user space can figure it out with a database if necessary, and then user space will make a call, and then the two will be bound together, and it will show up as a property on the DRM connector. And he has actually already posted patches for this, so which apparently have been received well, so this is a solved problem. So this is sort of a slide which has already been obsoleted mostly, which might still be good for some people to know. Are there any questions about this? Okay, well then, thanks for your time. And yes, right, which we're trying to fix now.
When you expose the backlight property in the connector, how are you going to deal with all the other bugs that you just talked about? What's this backlight property going to look like? Is it all the same problems?
Can someone give a mic to David? Because it's his code, so. Or maybe he can just come forward.
Well, so far we have already two SysFS attributes for brightness and actual brightness. And they behave differently, and just made the DRM property map one-to-one into the... Oh, no, I actually did scaling, but that was just due to a bug in DRM. But the idea is to have a one-to-one mapping on the brightness SysFS attribute.
But which is broken.
Yeah. So I don't mind adding any magic there, but...
So maybe if we're going to say this is going to be user space driven, or at least for laptops where it's a problem, we should make the DRM property always be perceived brightness and let user space load a lookup table.
I mean, what we already have to do is to support, we link one of the backlight interfaces to each connector, or we could actually link multiple ones if that's needed. And we allow user space to tell the kernel which one to link if the default doesn't work. And we could also just combine that with any kind of scale we want to have, or with anything else, and just write it into the same file with the same the same situation, so we get everything at one single point.
Yeah, so and then the end result will be that the DRM backlight connector or the backlight property on the DRM connector will always be perceived brightness, and zero means minimum usable level and not off.
Sounds good.
So maybe you need to do a V2 of your patch head and document that clearly. That it will mean that.
We'll do that.
Okay, well then I'm done. I actually didn't put up a questions sheet anymore because I wanted to keep it short, and hopefully the next speaker can come up now.
Yeah, sure. So Laurie, if you're ready.
Thank you.